ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಬಿಂಬ ಪ್ರತಿಬಿಂಬ ಭಾವದ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮುಗಿದಿದೆ. ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಿನ್ನೆ ಈ ಮುಷ್ಟಿ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಏನಿದೆ, ಆ ಮುಷ್ಟಿ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಅದು ಪ್ರವಾಹತಃ ಅನಾದಿ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಅನಂತ ಎಂಬಂಥ ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಜೀವರುಗಳು ಅನಂತವಾಗಿದ್ದರಿಂದ ಎಂದೂ ಕೂಡ ಜೀವರುಗಳು ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಈ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಏನಿದೆ ಇದು ಕೂಡ ಇದು ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿ ಇರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದರಿಂದ ಶೂನ್ಯತ್ವ ಎಂಬುದು ಎಂದೂ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಎಂದೂ ಕೂಡ ಜೀವರುಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಖಾಲಿಯಾದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ವಾತಾವರಣ ನಿರ್ಮಾಣವಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಬಂತು, ಹಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಇಂದ್ರಾದಿ ಪದದಲ್ಲಿರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಜೀವರುಗಳು ಖಾಲಿಯಾದರೆ, ಈಗಿನ ಇಂದ್ರ ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಂದ್ರ ಪದವಿಗೆ ಇನ್ಯಾರೂ ಸಿಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಆವಾಗ ಆ ಪದವಿಯನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ನಿಭಾಯಿಸುವುದು? ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಪದವಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಜೀವರುಗಳು ಸಿಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಆವಾಗ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಪದವಿ ಖಾಲಿ ಇರಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಏನು ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಿದೆ, ಈ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆಗಳು ಪ್ರತಿ ಸೃಷ್ಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರತ್ಯೇಕ ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಹಾಗಿರುವಾಗ ಇದನ್ನೇ ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಅವಲಂಬಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಗಣವೂ ಕೂಡ ಅನಂತ. ಗಣ ಅನಂತಮೇವ ಗಣಶೋಸ್ತಿ, ಗಣಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಅನಂತ. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಗಣ, ಇಂದ್ರಗಣ, ರುದ್ರಗಣ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಶೇಷಗಣ, ಗರುಡಗಣ, ಹೀಗೆ ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಜೀವರುಗಳಿಗೆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನಬದ್ಧವಾದಂತಹ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ಗಳು ಯಾವುದಿದೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಜನರಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸಂವಿಧಾನಬದ್ಧವಾಗದೇ ಇದ್ದಂಥ ಪೋಸ್ಟು ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಪದವಿ, ಇಂದ್ರ ಪದವಿ, ರುದ್ರ ಪದವಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಭಗವಂತನ ಸಂವಿಧಾನಬದ್ಧವಾದಂತಹ ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳು. ಆ ಸ್ಥಾನಗಳಿಗೆ ಎಂದೂ ಕೂಡ ಜನ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಆಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇತ್ತಂ ತದ ಸಕಲ ಕಾಲಗತ ಪ್ರವೃತ್ತಿ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಜಗಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಇಲ್ಲ ಎಂಬುದನ್ನು ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಏತೈಹಿ ಸುರಾದಿಭಿಃ ಅತಿಪ್ರತಿಭಾತಿಯುಕ್ತೈಃ ಯುಕ್ತೈಃ ಸಹೈವ ಸತತಂ ಪ್ರವಿಚಿಂತಯದ್ಭಿಃ ಪೂರ್ತೇಃ ಅಚಿಂತ್ಯಮಹಿಮಃ ಪರಮಪರಾತ್ಮ ನಾರಾಯಣೋಸ್ಯ ಗುಣವಿಸ್ತೃತಿರನ್ಯಗಾಕ್ವಾಂ. ಈಗ ಭಗವತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪವನ್ನೇ ಪುನಃ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ, ಅನಂತ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಅಧಿಕವಾದಂತಹ ಅನಂತವಾದ ಯಾವುದು ಎಂಬುದನ್ನು ಪುನಃ ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟೀಕರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಸದೃಶವಾದಂಥ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅನಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅನಂತ ಅನಂತಗಳಿವೆ, ಅನಂತಗಳಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಅನಂತ ಅನಂತಗಳಿವೆ. ಆ ಅನಂತ ಅನಂತಗಳಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಅತಿಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದಂತಹ ಅನಂತ್ಯ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಗಳು ಮಾತ್ರ. ಹೇಗೆ ಮೊನ್ನೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಇವತ್ತಿನ ತನಕ ಎಷ್ಟು ದಿನಗಳಾಯಿತು, ಎಷ್ಟು ತಿಂಗಳಾಯಿತು, ಎಷ್ಟು ಗಂಟೆಗಳಾಯಿತು, ಎಷ್ಟು ನಿಮಿಷಗಳಾಯಿತು, ಎಷ್ಟು ಸೆಕೆಂಡುಗಳಾಯಿತು, ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ವಿಮರ್ಶೆ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಅನಂತವೇ. ಎಷ್ಟು ದಿವಸಗಳು ಸಂಧಿವು, ಅನಂತ ದಿವಸಗಳು. ಎಷ್ಟು ತಿಂಗಳುಗಳು ಕಳೆದು ಹೋದವು, ಅನಂತ ದಿವಸಗಳು ತಿಂಗಳುಗಳು. ಆದರೆ ತಿಂಗಳ ಮಾಸಾನಂತ್ಯಕ್ಕಿಂತ ದಿನಾನಂತ್ಯ ಎಂಬುದು ದೊಡ್ಡದು, ದಿನಾನಂತ್ಯಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಗಂಟೆಯ ಅನಂತ್ಯ ದೊಡ್ಡದು. ಹೀಗೆ ಒಂದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಒಂದು ಅನಂತ ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡದು ಆಗ್ತಾ ಅಂತಿಮವಾಗಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಅನಂತ್ಯ ಯಾವುದು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅನಂತ ಜೀವರಾಶಿಗಳು ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಸೇರಿ ಅನಂತ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣ ಮುಗಿಯುವುದೇ. ಅನಂತ ಜೀವರಾಶಿಗಳು, ಅದು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯ ಜೀವರುಗಳಲ್ಲ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾದಿ ಅತಿ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಯುಕ್ತರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಅನಂತ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ದೇವರ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ 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 ಹೋದರೆ ಅದು ಮುಗಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅನಂತಗಳ ಪೈಕಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಒಂದು ಉಚ್ಚವಾದಂತಹ ಅನಂತ, ಅದು ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಈ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯ ಇದ್ದದ್ದರಿಂದ ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯ ಉಳಿದ ಅನಂತಗಳಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಆವಾಗ ಭಗವಂತನ ಮಹತ್ವ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಭಗವಂತರ ಗುಣಾನಂತ್ಯದ ಎದುರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಅನಂತ್ಯವೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಏತೈಹಿ ಸುರಾದಿಭಿಹಿ ಅತಿ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾದಿಯುಕ್ತೈ, ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾದಿದೇವತೆಗಳು ಜ್ಞಾನದ ಮೂಲ, ಅಂತಹ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾದಿದೇವತೆಗಳು ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರಲ್ಲ, ಸಹೈವ ಯುಕ್ತೈ, ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸೇರಿ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣವನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗೋದು. ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದರೆ ಸಹೈವ ಸತತಂ ಪ್ರವಿಚಿಂತಯದ್ಭಿ ಅಚಿಂತ್ಯ ಮಹಿಮಃ ಪೂರ್ತೇ ನ, ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಆಗೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಈಗ ಅವರು ಅನಂತ ಗುಣಗಳ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡುವ ಕ್ರಿಯೆಯನ್ನು ಭಗವಂತನೇ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ದೇವರ ಗುಣಗಳನ್ನು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ 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 ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೇರಿ ಅನಂತ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರಲ್ಲ, ದೇವರ ಗುಣಗಳ ಅನಂತ ಒಂದು ಬೇರೆ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಈ ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಗುಣ ಉಂಟಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅನಂತ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣದ ಅನಂತ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಅಧಿಕವಾದಂತಹ ಅನಂತ್ಯ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಭಗವಂತನಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ವೋತ್ತಮತ್ವ ಇದರಿಂದ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ, ನಾರಾಯಣನಿಗೆ ಸರ್ವೋತ್ತಮತ್ವ ಎಂಬುದು ಇದರಿಂದ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಗುಣವಿಸ್ತೃತಿ ಅನ್ಯಗ ಕ್ವ, ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಇಂತಹ ಗುಣ ವಿಸ್ತಾರವುಳ್ಳವರು ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದರ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆ ಒಂದು ಅಂಶವೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ, ಅನಂತ ಜೀವರಾಶಿಗಳು ಅನಂತ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಲೆಕ್ಕ ಮಾಡಿದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಮುಗಿಯದೇ ಇದ್ದಂತಹ ಗುಣವುಳ್ಳತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಭಗವಂತ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಆವಾಗ ಅವನು ಈ ಅನಂತ ಗುಣ ಜೀವನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನು ಸೇರ್ತಾನೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅತಿಪ್ರತಿಪಾದಯುಕ್ತೈ ಸಹೈವ ಯುಕ್ತೈ ಏತೈ ಸತತಂ ಪ್ರವಿಚಿಂತಯದ್ಭಿ ಏತೈ ಸುರಾದಿಭಿ ಅಚಿಂತ್ಯ ಮಹಿಮಃ ಪೂರ್ತೇ ಅಚಿಂತ್ಯ ಮಹಿಮಃ ಅಯಂ ಪರಮಃ ಪರಾತ್ಮ ವರ್ತತೆ ಅಸ್ಯ ಗುಣವಿಸ್ತೃತಿ ಅನ್ಯಗ ಕ್ವ. ಈ ನಾರಾಯಣನ ಗುಣವಿಸ್ತಾರ ಬೇರೆಯಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಕಾಣಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಾಮ್ಯಂ ನ ಚಾಸ್ಯ ಪರಮೇಣ ಚ ಕೇನ ಚಾಪ್ಯಂ ಮುಕ್ತೇನ ಚ ಕ್ವಚಿದತಸ್ತ್ವವಿಧ ಕುತೋಸ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಪ್ಯೇತ ಚೇತನ ಗಣೈಃ ಸತತ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರೈಃ ನಿತ್ಯಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ವಪುಷಃ ಪರಮಾತ್ಪರಸ್ಯ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಭಗವಂತನ ಸ್ವರೂಪವನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಈಗ ನೀವು ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇಂತಹ ನಾರಾಯಣನಿಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸಮನಾದವನು ಇರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಸಾಮ್ಯಂ ನ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಅವನಿಗೆ ಸಮ ಆಗಬಹುದಲ್ವಾ? ಈಗ ನಾವು ಸಮ ಆಗದೆ ಹೋದರೂ ಕೂಡ ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಅವರು ಒಂದೇ ಆಗಬಹುದಲ್ವಾ? ಅದ್ಯಾಕೆ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದಾಗುವುದು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದರೇನೆ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಆಯಿತು ಸಮ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ. ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುವ ತನಕ ನಾವು ಸಮ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಒಪ್ಪಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನು ಸಮ ಆಗುವುದು ಹೇಗೆ? ಈಗ ಅವನು ಸಮ ಅಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಮುಂದೆ ಅವನು ಹೋಗಿ ಸಮ ಆಗ್ತಾನೆ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಅವಾಗ ಈಗಿನ ಸಮ ಅಲ್ಲ ಎಂಬಂತಹ ಒಂದು ದೋಷ ಬಂದೇ ಬಂತಲ್ಲ. ಸಮ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದರೆ ಅವನು ಅನಾದಿ ಕಾಲದಿಂದ ಇವನಿಗೆ ಸಮ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಮ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಅವಾಗ ಈಗ ಸಮ ಆಗದೇ ಹೋದದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅದು ನಿಜವಾದ ಸಾಮ್ಯನೇ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಸಾಮ್ಯ ಎಂಬುದು ಎಂದೂ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಾಮ್ಯವೇ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಭೇದ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ? ಈಗ ಐಕ್ಯ ಆಗೋದು ಹೇಗೆ? ಹತ್ತಿರ 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 ಬಂದು ಐಕ್ಯ ಆಗಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಹತ್ತಿರದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಐಕ್ಯ ಹೇಗೆ ಬಂತು? ಭಗವಂತನ ಸಾಮ್ಯವನ್ನು ಯಾರೂ ಕೂಡ ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಎಂದೂ ಯಾರೂ ಭಗವಂತನ ಸಾಮ್ಯವನ್ನೇ ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದ ಮೇಲೆ ಐಕ್ಯವನ್ನಾದರೂ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೊಂದುವುದು? ಐಕ್ಯ ಹೊಂದಬೇಕಾದರೆ ಏನು ಬೇಕು? ಸಮ ಆಗಲೇಬೇಕು. ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸ್ಟೇಜು ಸಮ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಐಕ್ಯ. ಆ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸ್ಟೇಜಿಗೇನೆ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಐಕ್ಯವಾದರೂ ಹೇಗೆ? ಪರಮೇಣ ಅಸ್ಯ ಜೀವಸ್ಯ ಕೇನಾಪಿ ಮುಕ್ತೇನಾಪಿ ಸಾಮ್ಯಂ ನ, ಸಾಮ್ಯವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅತಃ ಅಸ್ಯ ಅಭಿದ ಕುತಃ, ಅಭೇದವಾದರೂ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ? ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅಭೇದ ಎಂಬುದು ಅದು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಅಸಮರ್ಥನೀಯ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ವಸ್ತುವು ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಸ್ತುವಿನ ಒಂದಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಒಂದಾಗುವುದು ಎಂಬುದು ಅದು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಅಸಮರ್ಥನೀಯವಾದದ್ದು. ಈಗ ಹಾಲು ಮತ್ತು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ದೃಷ್ಟ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಹೀಗೆ ಹಾಲಿಗೆ ನೀರು ಬೆರೆಸಿದರೆ ಹಾಲು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾದಾಗೆ ಜೀವನು ಪರಮಾತ್ಮನು ಒಂದಾಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟ, ಯಾಕಾಗಬಾರದು? ಹಾಲು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಾಲು ಮತ್ತು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದಾದಾಗೆ ಕಾಣ್ತದಲ್ವಾ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಕಾಣೋದು ಮಾತ್ರ, ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ಒಂದಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಹಾಲು ಮತ್ತು ನೀರನ್ನು ಬೆರೆಸಿದಾಗ ಅದು ಒಂದೇ ಆಗಿದ್ದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಲೀಟರ್ ಹಾಲಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಲೀಟರ್ ನೀರನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸಿದಾಗ ಅದು ಎರಡು ಲೀಟರ್ ಯಾಕಾಯಿತು? ಒಂದೇ ಆಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಅದು ಒಂದೇ ಲೀಟರ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು. ಹಾಲು ಮತ್ತು ನೀರು ಅದು ಒಂದೇ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವುದಾದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಲೀಟರ್ ಹಾಲಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಲೀಟರ್ ನೀರನ್ನು ಸೇರಿಸಿದಾಗ ಅದು ಎರಡು ಲೀಟರ್ ಆಗಬಾರದು, ಒಂದೇ ಲೀಟರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಎರಡು ಲೀಟರ್ ಆದದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನರ್ಥ? ಒಂದಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದಾದ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾಣೋದು. ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಹಾಲು ಮತ್ತು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಆಚಾರ್ಯರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಂಸಕ್ಷೀರನ್ಯಾಯ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧವಾದ, ಹಂಸ ಪಕ್ಷಿಗೆ ನೀರು ಬೆರೆಸಿದ ಹಾಲನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟರೆ ಅದು ಹಾಲನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ತಗೊಳ್ತದೆ, ನೀರನ್ನು ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಅಭೇದ ಆಯಿತು ಹೇಳಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಬಾರದು. ಹಾಲು ನೀರು ಒಂದಾಗಿದ್ದ ಹೌದಾದರೆ ಹಂಸ ಪಕ್ಷಿಯು ಒಂದಾದಂತಹ ಹಾಲು ನೀರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಲನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೇಗೆ ಹೇರುತ್ತದೆ, ನೀರನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ? ನಾವು ಹಾಲು ಕುಡಿಯುತ್ತೇವೆ, ಹಾಲು ಕುಡಿಯುವಾಗ ನಾವು ಕುಡಿದಂಥ ಹಾಲು ಮೂತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ಹಾಲಿನ ಬಿಳಿ ಬಣ್ಣ ಹೋಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀರು ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಹಾಲು ಕುಡಿದದ್ದರಿಂದಲೇ ಮೂತ್ರ ಹೋಗುದು, ಆದರೆ ಹಾಲಿನ ಬಿಳಿ ಬಣ್ಣ ಹೋಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನರ್ಥ? ಹಾಲು ಬೇರೆ, ಹಾಲಿನ ಬಿಳಿ ಬಣ್ಣ ಬೇರೆ, ಹಾಲು ಬೇರೆ, ನೀರು ಬೇರೆ, ಭಿನ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟ ಭಿನ್ನ ಧರ್ಮ ಅಷ್ಟ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ವಸ್ತುವು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದಾಗಲು ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಿರುವಾಗ ಅನಂತ ಗುಣಗಳಿಂದ ಕೂಡಿದಂತಹ ಭಗವಂತನು, ಅನೇಕ ದೋಷಗಳಿಂದ ಕೂಡಿದಂತಹ ಜೀವನು, ಇವರು ಒಂದಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಕಾಮನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮಿಗೆ ಬರಬೇಕು, ಕಾಮನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರ್ಮಿಗೇ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದಾಗುವುದು. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಕೇನಾಪಿ ಅಭಿದ ನ, ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇವ ಕೊಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಮೋಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ ಮೇಲೇನೆಲ್ಲ ಇವರು ಅಭೇದವರು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಭಗವಂತ ಅವನು ಸರ್ವಜ್ಞ ಮತ್ತು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಬುದ್ಧಿವಂತ. ಯಾವ ಬುದ್ಧಿವಂತರೂ ಕೂಡ ತನ್ನಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕೆಳಗಿನವರಿಂದ ಅಭೇದವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯಸುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಈ ಭಗವಂತ ಸರ್ವಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠನಾಗಿದ್ದವನು, ಶುದ್ಧನಾಗಿದ್ದವನು, ಅಶುದ್ಧನ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆದರೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಶುದ್ಧವಾದಂತಹ ಗಂಗಾ ಜಲವನ್ನು ಚರಂಡಿ ನೀರನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಗಂಗೆಗೆ ಅಪೇಕ್ಷೆ ಉಂಟ? ನನಗೆ ಚರಂಡಿ ನೀರೆಲ್ಲ ಬರಲಿ, ಜೀವನಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಚರಂಡಿ ನೀರಿನ ಹಾಗೆ, ಭಗವಂತ ಗಂಗಾ ನದಿ ಹಾಗೆ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಎರಡೂ ಒಂದಾಯಿತು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಭಗವಂತ ಅಶಕ್ತನಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ಸರಿ, ಏನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದಾಗಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟೆವು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳು. ಭಗವಂತ ಅಶಕ್ತನಲ್ಲ, ಸರ್ವಶಕ್ತನಾಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಸರ್ವಗುಣ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣನಾಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ಸರ್ವಗುಣ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣನಾಗಿದ್ದವನು, ಅವನು ಸರ್ವಸಮರ್ಥನಾಗಿದ್ದವನು, ಅವನು ತನ್ನಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕೆಳಗಿನವರಿಂದ ಅಭೇದವನ್ನು ಯಾಕೆ ಬಯಸ್ತಾನೆ? ಸಾಧ್ಯವೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ವಸ್ತುವು ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವಸ್ತುವಿನಿಂದ ಅಭೇದವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಭಿನ್ನವಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯವಿಲ್ಲವಾದ್ದರಿಂದ ಸಾಮ್ಯವನ್ನೇ ಹೊಂದಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ನು ಅಭೇದವಂತೂ ಸುತರಾಂ ಅದು ಅಶಕ್ಯ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ನಿತ್ಯ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ಉಪುಷಃ ಪರಮಾತ್ಪರಸ್ಯ ಚೇತ ಸತತ ಅಸ್ವತಂತ್ರೈ ಚೇತನಗಣೈ ಅಭಿದ ಕುತಃ ಪ್ರಾಪ್ಯೇತ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಅವನ ಅಧೀನ, ಅವನ ಅಧೀನವಾಗಿರುವಾಗ ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿ ನಿನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಅಭೇದವನ್ನು ಹೊಂತೇನೆ, ಐಕ್ಯವನ್ನು ಹೊಂತೇನೆ ಎಂಬುದು ಸಾಧ್ಯವೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ವಿಶ್ವತರಕೆಯನ್ನು ಭಗವತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪವನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಬಂದರೂ ಆ ಭಗವತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪದ ಒಂದು ಉಪಸಂಹಾರ, ಭಗವತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪ ಎಂಬುದು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಭಿನ್ನವಾಗಿದೆ, ಸಮಸ್ತ ಗುಣಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿದೆ, ಯಾವ ದೋಷದ ಲವಲೇಶನೂ ಅವನಲ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವನಷ್ಟು ಒಂದು ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠವಾದಂಥ ವಸ್ತು ಜಗತ್ತಿನಲ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವನಲ್ಲಿರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಗುಣದ ಆನಂತ್ಯ ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅವನೇ ಸರ್ವಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ಭಗವತ್ ಸ್ವರೂಪವನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಣಯ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ಶ್ಲೋಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪಸಂಹಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಕ್ಷಯಂ ಕರ್ಮ ಯಸ್ಮಿನ್ ಪರೇ ಸ್ವರ್ಪಿತಂ ಪ್ರಕ್ಷಯಂ ಯಾಂತಿ ದುಃಖಾನಿ ಯನ್ನಾಮತಃ ಅಕ್ಷರೋ ಯೋಜನ ಸರ್ವದೈವಾಮೃತಃ ಕುಕ್ಷಿಗಂ ಯಸ್ಯ ವಿಶ್ವಂ ಸದಾ ಜಾಧಿಕಂ प्रीणयामो वासुदेवं देवतामंडलं खंडमंडलं प्रीणयामो वासुदेवं इवत्तु नम्म श्रीकृष्ण वृंदावनक्के बहळ ओंदु संतोषद विषय संस्कृत ಪಂಡಿತರ ಪರಂಪರೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಕಾಣಬಹುದಾದಂತಹ ಒಬ್ಬ ಶ್ರೇಷ್ಠ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಆರ್ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಇವತ್ತು ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ವೃಂದಾವನಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಮಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರನ್ನು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದರೆ ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಪಂಡಿತರ ವರ್ಣನೆ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು ಬರೀ ಶಬ್ದಮಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಹಿಂದಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಂತೆಂತಹ ಪಂಡಿತರು ಇದ್ದರು, ಅವರ ಬುದ್ಧಿಶಕ್ತಿ ಎಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಎಂಬುದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕಥೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಶತಾವಧಾನಿಗಳು, ದಶಾವಧಾನಿಗಳು ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳನ್ನು ಇಡೀ ವೇದಗಳನ್ನೇ ಬಾಯಿಪಾಠ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡವರು, ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಸಮಸ್ತ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು. ಹಿಂದಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳೇ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಪ್ರಿಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಹಬ್ಬಬ್ಬ ಅಂದರೆ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆಯುವುದು. ಅಂತಹ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಗೆ ಉಳಿದು ಬಂದವು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ಬರೀ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಪವರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ, ಉಪದೇಶದಿಂದ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಗ್ರಂಥವೂ ಕೂಡ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿದ್ದು ಶಿಷ್ಯರಿಂದ ಶಿಷ್ಯರಿಗೆ ಬಂದು. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾವು ಪ್ರಿಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಹಿಂದಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಪಂಡಿತರುಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲ ಗ್ರಂಥಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲೇ ಇಟ್ಟು ತಪ್ಪದೆ ಸಾವಿರಾರು ವರ್ಷಗಳಿಂದ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದು ಇವತ್ತು ಕಥೆಯಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಆದರೆ ಅಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಬುದ್ಧಿಶಕ್ತಿ, ಅಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಗ್ರಹಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ, ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಕಾಣಬಹುದಾದಂತಹ ಒಬ್ಬ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಆರ್ ಗಣೇಶನ್. ಇವತ್ತು ನೂರು ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಏಕಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಹಣ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಸೂಪರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಅವರು. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಏನು ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆ ಅದು ಸುಪೀರಿಯರ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಇದ್ದು ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಅವರದು. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅವರು ವಿಶೇಷವಾದಂಥ ಸ್ಥಾನಮಾನ, ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರೀತಾರೆ, ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿ ಕೊಡತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಗಣೇಶನ್. ಅವರ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿ ಅವರಿಂದ ದೊರೆಯಬಹುದು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಭಾವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ಶತಾವಧಾನ ಪರಂಪರೆ, ಹಿಂದಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕ ಕಡೆ ಪಂಡಿತರುಗಳು ಶತಾವಧಾನ ಮಾಡಿ ಆ ಒಂದು ತಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಅವರು ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತಪಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದರು. ಅಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಜ್ವಲಂತ ನಿದರ್ಶನವಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಉಳಿದದ್ದು ನಮ್ಮ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ. ಕೆಲವೇ ಕೆಲವು ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಅವರು ಬಹಳ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅನೇಕ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನು ಏಕಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಹಣ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಪುನಃ ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಪುನಃ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡತಕ್ಕಂತಹ, ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬರೇ ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ. ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಬೇರೆ, ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಬೇರೆ. ಕೆಲವರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಕೆಲವರಿಗೆ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ತತ್ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಆದರೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ನು ಎರಡೂ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಬ್ಬ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಆರ್ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಪ್ರತಿಭಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ, ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ, ಹೇಳಿದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಮರಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಆ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಯನ್ನು ಕೇಳಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ತನ್ನ ಪ್ರತಿಭೆಯಿಂದಲೇ ಅನೇಕ ಒಂದು ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯಿಕವಾದಂತಹ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಅವರು ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಹೀಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸೃಷ್ಟಿ ಮಾಡತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಶಕ್ತಿ, ಮೈಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸ್ಮರಣ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಮೈಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನು ಗ್ರಾಸ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು. ಅಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಸೂಪರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಆರ್ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಅವರು ಇವತ್ತು ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಬಹಳ ಮುಖ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ವೃಂದಾವನಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಮಿಸಿದ್ದು ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ವೃಂದಾವನ ನೂತನವಾಗಿ ಸಿಲಿಕಾನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೋ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಪ್ರಾಯ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡುವುದು ನಮ್ಮ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ವೃಂದಾವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೇ ಮೊದಲು ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ನಾವು ಭಾವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವು ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷ ಪಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅಂತಹ ಆರ್ ಗಣೇಶನ್ ಅವರು ಇವತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಿಜ್ಞಾಸುಗಳಿಗೆ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಪಾಂಡಿತ್ಯದ ಸವಿಯನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಉಡಬಡಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಭಾಳ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಅವರಿಗೆ ವಿಶೇಷವಾದಂತಹ ಕೃಷ್ಣನ ಅನುಗ್ರಹ ಇರಲಿ, ರಾಯರ ಅನುಗ್ರಹ ಇರಲಿ, ಪಕ್ಕ ಪ್ರಾಣದೇವರ ಅನುಗ್ರಹ ಇರಲಿ ಅಂಥೇಳಿ ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸ್ತಾ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಈ ಪ್ರಸಾದವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ನೀಡ್ತಾ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ
ಶ್ರೀಪಾದರು ಗಣೇಶ ಅವರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸುಂದರವಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಗಣಪತಿ ಆಕಾಶದ ಅಧಿಪತಿ. ನಾವು ಏನೇನು ಶಬ್ದನ ಆಚೆ ತರ್ತೀವಿ ಅದಷ್ಟನ್ನು ಗ್ರಹಿಸಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆದರೆ ಈ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸು ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೌಡ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರ್ ವನ್. ಅದನ್ನು ತರಂಗಾಂತರದಲ್ಲಿ ತೆಗೆದು ಅದನ್ನು ರೀಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಎನ್ಹ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಆಚೆ ತರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಗಣೇಶನ ಒಂದು ಕೃಪೆ ಇರಲೇಬೇಕು. ಅಂತಹ ಮಹಾಕೃಪೆಯನ್ನು ಪಡೆದಿರುವಂಥ ನಮ್ಮ ಗಣೇಶ ಅವರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನೆಲ್ಲನೂ ಉದ್ದೇಶಿಸಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಮಗೂ ಜ್ಞಾನದ ಬೆಳಕನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಓಂ ತತ್ಸತ್. Can all of you understand Kannada? Okay. Itarhi Angla Bhashayam Eva Ichami. Om Tat Sat. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Dharma Guptre Shri Krishnaya. Having salutated at the lotus feet of my Ishtadeva Bhagavan Shri Krishna and also the most intimate and authentic mediator to my Lord Shri Shri Sugadendra Tirtha Swamiji, who has graced on this occasion. And it's my good fortune that before 15 years when I had come to this place, I had my good fortune to pay my respects to Swamiji. He was rarely here at that time also, and after 15 years I am coming, and again I am happily sitting at his gracious presence. And this is in the divine destiny, that's what I feel. It's not an accident or a coincidence or a strange thing to happen. So I often feel that Udupi Krishna, my most beloved Upasya Devata, has graced generously on me. And today's topic as it is already announced, a few verses taken from one of the most charming and haunting works of Sanskrit produced by a very gifted poet, Leelashuka. Leelashuka Bilvamangala, it's also his name. To which province he belongs to, it's very difficult to say. But one thing is sure, all great people are so sought of that everybody feels that great personality belongs to our province. And so Keralites often and often say, Krishna's such a great devotee, Bilvamangala Leelashuka, belongs to our province. And they even have several stories also. This Krishna Karanamrita literally meaning it is the ambrosia to the ears. This is best among the Karanamritas. There are several Karanamritas, Rama Karanamrita, Devi Karanamrita, Shiva Karanamrita and all. But Krishna Karanamrita, as best among the gods, is Sri Krishna. So is best among the compositions based on the genre of Karanamrita is this work. And Kerala people say that Leelashuka started composing these verses. He started singing one after the other in front of the divine image of the Lord. And to those verses, Lord too appreciated with a nodding. When he started nodding the heads, such verses were only collected, and thus he belongs to Kerala, and they even show a place where that happened. And Andhra people are not falling behind. They say, Krishna Karanamrita is the most popular devotional hymn in the whole land of Andhra, and many poets have appreciated. And a great poetess like Ganga Devi, who was the daughter-in-law of Bukkaraya, the person who was the founder of Vijayanagar, one of the founders of Vijayanagar, she, Ganga Devi, hailing from Andhra Pradesh, she says, Karanamrita Kavir Giraha. So an Andhra poetess writing in Sanskrit, quoting and praising Krishna Karanamrita Kara Leelashuka, it is an indication that he belongs to us. But the Bengalis, they are always ahead of everybody. For that matter, the Indian freedom struggle also started from there, and even the Nobel laureate came from that place, and all that glory is there to Bengal. And they say, it's only in Bengal such things can happen. Gauranga Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the great devotee of Bhagavan Shri Krishna, he was so fond of Karanamrita, and even he collected with great difficulty the first part of it, the 100 verses in the first Ashvasa, and that became one of the Prasthanatraya in his Achintya Bheda Veda tradition. So it is from Bengal. In between Andhra and Bengal we have Odisha, Odradesha. The Oriya people say, how can we forget Leelashuka? It is our Jagannatha, the great Lord, the Lord of the whole universe. His greater devotee is that person, and he came here, he settled here, and he sang in front of our Lord, and so it is that. Last but not least, our Karnataka people also come. They say, well, it's all right, but Krishna belong to part of Karnataka, that is Tulu Nadu. And Swamiji knows one very good scholar from Udupi, Nitalapura Krishnamurti. He has produced a worthy thesis, Contribution of Tulu Nadu to Sanskrit Literature, where he establishes how Leelashuka belongs to the coastal Karnataka, the Leela Bhumi of Acharya Madhva. So, in that way, every province has claimed Leelashuka as his. Yes, always this spirit is very good. We should love the lovable, venerable, noble, gifted men, and we should respect them anywhere and everywhere they may exist. They belong to us. As the great sage Basavanna says, Ivanarava, Ivanarava, Ivanarava Nennadiraya, Ivanammava, Ivanammava, Ivanammava Nenisaya. Don't make me fall into such sick community where none should ask me, who are you, who are you, who are you? And one and all should recognize me as mine, ours and ours. That should be the tradition. And Sanatana Dharma has, with all open heart and opening choice for one and all, Ano Bhadra Krata Voyantu Vishvataha, let noble thoughts and also people who thought so, they shall come to our folds. And this Leelashuka belongs to Sanatana Dharma and the great Bharatiya Bhumi. But we don't know anything about him. Many stories are there, but we don't know what is the real historicity. But we should not worry more about that. Bhakshitavya apupakim ganyani susharanikim. Should we eat the cake or should we start counting the porous holes there? So we should not bother more about time and place of a person. We should bother more about his production, his achievement and his contribution. We have several stories. All the stories direct at one point. He was a really God-realized person. And he was a great devotee and a great poet. And everything is realized from his poem itself. It's approximately a short treatise of 300 verses divided into 3 chapters. But it is a masterly stroke and it is equally appealing to the musicians, the dancers and even the people who love literature. And even the people who want to learn Sanskrit easily, they too should follow it because they are having manifold advantages. One is they will be learning Sanskrit, the divine tongue, and the other one is they will be enjoying a devotional hymn. Instead of reading so many other things, better read a devotional hymn. And instead of reading so many other devotional hymns, it is best to read a devotional hymn on Shri Krishna, the most charming God in the universe. Can we think of any other God as charming, as endearing, as endarling as Shri Krishna? None. Umshi vibhushita karan navaneera dabhat pitambara daruna bimba phala darushtat mugdhendu sundara mukhat arvinda netrat krishnat param kimapi tattva maham na jane. I know not any other entity better than this. This is how the wonder of Krishna will always work out. Sanskrit tradition is so great. You see, while learning grammar in different cases, it is John or it is X, and from X to X, by X, of X, in X, in all that, instead of learning Ramaha Ramo Rameti, He Rama He Ramo He Ramaha Ramam Ramo Raman Ramena Ramabhyam Ramahi, like that the cases are Hari Hari Haraya He Hari He Hari He Haraya or Rama Rame Ramaha. Like that all the Akaranta, Akaranta, Ikaranta and all these varieties, they are after different gods and goddesses. Why not Akaranta Pullingo Ghata Shabdaha Ghata Ghata Ghataha, part, from part, with part, by part, two parts, many parts, like that. Only Rama, why not? Because 28 times you have to repeat the name in 3 Vachanas and 8 Vibhaktis. Instead of remembering the name of Tom, Dick and Harry or mud pots and bowls and other things, why not Rama, why not Krishna, why not Rama, why not Hari? So this is how Sanskrit is Sanskrit, Sanskritam, perfection, because in any approach it brings in spirituality. It is manifolded advantage for our tradition. And thus Leela Shukas Krishna Karanamrita is an eternal treasure for learning the divine language. And also so musical, verily musical. Every line of it can be sung so well. In earlier tradition, in Carnatic music especially, Shloka Gana used to be one part in the Sangeeta Kacheri, the music concert. Then few verses from the Leela Shukas Karanamrita used to be an invariable appetizer. For example, the Sayankale Vanante Kusumita Samaye Saikate Chandrikayam or Kasturi Tilakam Lalata Palake or Ayimurali Mukunda. These were the most popular things where the elaboration of the raga used to go along with the mood of it. I shall demonstrate it later. And not to speak about dance. In dance, what else apart from Krishna become the real worthy subject? We can't have any other gods. With all respect to all gods, we have to say that even the other avatars of Vishnu, they can't entertain so much as Krishna. We can't think of Rama dancing with girls, Rama burgling something. He is Maryada Purushottama. He'll always be decent and dignified. But Krishna, can be so many things at a time. He can lead the army towards victory. He can lead a mission of treaty as well. He can make a person who never uttered a lie to utter a lie. At the same time, he is Satya Pratigna, Satya Vak, Satya Dharma, Satya Swarupa, and all that. So, the seemingly contradicting things and apparently conflicting things can all be nullified and saturated and find their relevance in Krishna. And that's how in dance everything and anything is possible by using the theme of Krishna. You see, in any religion, how many gods can dance? How many gods can play music? How many gods can sing? And how many gods can entertain? How many gods can become babies, children and what not? We don't have any stories of any other god becoming a baby. We don't have any other god showing so many balalilas. All these things make one exploit the possibilities of Krishna as expounded in the Karnamrita of Leela Shuka. Here, in this evening, I am going to present few verses of my choice. Every verse is a gem. It's so hard to make a choice, but time is a unforgiving constraint, and that's why I am resorting to few verses. We all know we work for so many companies, so many industries, so many institutions. Whether we like it or not, it's our living. It may not be our life. It becomes our life, means it is a passion. We'll never get tired of. But when it is living, we work hard, we feel harder, and it is the hardest moment also as well. Many times, even for gifted poets also, for their physical needs, for their material needs, they may have to compose few verses on people whom they may not like. A king may order, compose few verses on me, or compose few verses on king's beloved. It has to be done. He's a professional writer, of course. Whether we like it or not, we have to do sometimes. And Leela Shuka, in his Purvashrama, perhaps he had done so. And that's why he feels bad. And he begs pardon at the lotus feet of Goddess of Learning, Saraswati. Matarnatav param anuchitam yatkalanam purastat astashankam jatara pitari purtaye nartitasi tatkshantavyam sahajasarale vatsale vani kuryam prayaschittam gunagananaya gopaveshasya vishnoho. O mother, I have employed wrongly you for praising so many wretched people for 2 square meals. The stomach is such a bottomless pit. I have misused and abused you for this. Nothing is a greater sin than this. Please excuse me, for you are so compassionate and straightforward. Sahaja sarale vatsale. But I am not going to keep quiet now. Now that I have realized, I am going to emancipate my sins. I am going to take a prayaschitta as well by employing you for the most worthy act of praising the childhood of my Lord Krishna. O Saraswati, you become Sarthavati, Rasavati, Arthavati. You become much more meaningful. As Kalidasa says in his Raghuvamsha, when all these gods had gone to Mahavishnu for pleading Ramavatara so that Ravana will be vanquished, then Vishnu starts answering. Then Kalidasa says, Saraswati, she became sanctified because she'll all be dancing in others' mouths also. What in our mouth? Saliva. So, Saraswati is got impurified, and to find purification, she has to go to the asylum Mahavishnu. Then only she can get purified. And so, Saraswati, because of misuse and abuse of others, will get cleansed. We know Ganga will be cleansing our sins, and where that sins should go, she has to find the lotus feet of Lord. So also Saraswati, when she is being misused and abused, she has to find ದ ಅಂಬ್ರೋಸಿಯಲ್ ಮೌತ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾವಿಷ್ಣು ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಕೈಶೋರಂ ದಟ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ಹುಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಮೀ ಪ್ರಾಯಶ್ಚಿತ್ತಂ ಗುಣಗಣನೆಯ ಗೋಪವೇಶಸ್ಯ ವಿಷ್ಣೋ ದಸ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಬೆಟರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈ ಸೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ದರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಚಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ Nothing and nothing is far more charming than Mahavishnu and incarnation in the form of Krishna. Kamam santu sahasra shakati paye madhurya dhuleya kah kamam va kamaniyata paranati swarajya baddhavrata naivaitair vivadamahe nachavayam deva priyam brumahe tat satyam ramaniyata paranati stvayeva parangata. I am not contending with people who give examples of beautiful things. I am not finding fault with people who are saying that this is beautiful, that is charming, that is attractive, and that is engrossing. We are not finding fault or taking bones with anybody. But one thing is true, O Krishna, I am just pleading this. It's not just to please you, appease you. For me to appease you. Beauty has found fulfillment in you. Tat satyam ramaniyata pranatistvayeva parangata. Means, it is so difficult to concentrate our mind at a place. Because things all around us may not be that attractive. But by fortune, Krishna is such an attractive thing. That's why he says, bhaktistvayastirataya bhagavan yadisyat daivenanah phalita divya kishoraveshe muktisvayam mukulita anjali sevatesman dharmarthaka manivaha samaya pratikshaha. O Lord, if at all we can foster devotion at your lotus feet, and it is so easy also, unlike the lofty Vedantic terms and also very difficult yogic postures and so hard and elaborate karmakanda in the form of rituals, it's all so difficult, but it's so easy to have bhakti in you, and you are such a charming young boy. You are in the form of such an attractive, eternally charming young boy, and that's why it is very, very easy for us to concentrate on you. Then moksha itself, absolute liberation that comes to us with a folded hand. Mukti swayam mukulitanjali sevate asman. And what about the other purusharthas, dharma, artha and kama? They are sending their visiting cards for our interview. They are waiting for us at our doorsteps. And we need not bother about the other purusharthas. When mukti itself is coming with folded hands to us, what about these things? They are tinsel. That way he says, and then he also says, well, there are many people who say that we have to go to Upanishads, we have to go to the Veda. Well, it's all good, but it's too hard. It's a hard nut to crack. Upasatam atmavidah puranah paramparastan nihitam guhayam vayam yashoda shishu bala leela katha sudha sindushu leelayamaha. May those great noble sages meditate on the absolute inner light, which is so difficult to see. We know that in the Mahanarayana Sutta, it is said, Nila toyada madhyastha vidyul lekheva bhaswara nivarashoka vattanvi pita bhaspastyanupama. Like that, in the heart, we have the divine light. And that is like the lighting in a water-bearing cloud, something like that. And the heart is something like adhomukham pundarikam, it's something like an inverted lotus. Santatagam sirabhistu lambatyakosha sannibham tasyante susharigam sukshmam tasmin sarvam vyavastitam. Like that, it is all said something about blood circulation itself. It is all being mentioned there. Well, it is so. But we are not for that. It's very hard. What is the first sutra of yoga? Sutras, what is the first aphorism? Atha yoganushasanam, yogaschitta vritti nirodha. You have to insulate the mind. It is very, very hard to achieve. But with respect to Krishna, it is not so. Every childhood act of Krishna, every mischief of him, is a marvel and it's a greater delight and enlightenment as well. So we are so fortunate to have that, and that's why I am very much content with your Balaleela, he says. Then he also says, oh sages, what for you are wandering and roaming directionlessly in the thick dense forests of the Upanishads? Very hard to think, very hard to come out. Paramimam upadesham adriyadvam nigamavaneshu nitanta charakinna vichinuta bhavaneshu vallavinam upanishadarthamulu kale nibaddham. Oh sages, listen to my good words. You take me to confidence. I am here to guide you. Don't wander in the never-ending difficulties of the Upanishadic forests. Your true message and meaning of the Upanishad is tied to the grinding stone somewhere in the corners of a gopi's hut. You know, Krishna was tied by Yashoda to the grounding, pounding stone. Ulukhala in Sanskrit, that is it. I think many of us would have seen it, for it's all the grinders, mixers here. Since 50 years or so, it's all become obsolete, and in the villages we can see. So it is the grinding stone. You can see even in Pompeii, even in Greece, even in Rome, they used to have that. Everywhere it used to be so. And to that Krishna was tied, and that was one of the leelas of Krishna, Yamalarjuna Bhanga. He pulled it. Along with that, he went in between two trees, Arjuna Vrikshas, and then those two people, sons of Kubera, Manigreva and Nalakubara, they were given back to their original forms, something like that. In the Mahabhagavatam it is there. He is saying, your Upanishadatta is tied to that stone. What for you are bothering about other things? So charmingly he says, Krishna is the highest truth. And then, you know, here at least we have GPS and other things, and that's why going to a place is not difficult. ಇಲ್ಲ, ನನಗಿದೇ ಹಿತವಾಗಿದೆ, ತೊಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. Nowadays we have so many options of locating a place and going easily. We need not ask for anybody for directions. But even now in India it is not so. We have to take the help of people. And somebody like me had approached Leela Ashoka. We want to go to the place of Krishna. Then he says, Agre dirghataro yam arjunataru tasya agrato vartani saghosham samupaiti tat parisare deshe kalindatmaja tasya astira kamal tamala kananatale chakram gavamcharayan balakkelati darshayishyati sake panthanam avyahatam. Oh my fellow traveler, you just look at this right in front of you. It's a big tree, and next to it is a small lane. You go by that. That will lead you to the banks of Yamuna. Nearby you have dense tamala trees grove, and there you have a boy. He will lead you to that direction. He will lead you to that way which will never turn you back. Panthanam avyahatam means if you go by the way of Krishna, you need not retrace. In the Brahma Sutras, the last sutra says, anavritti shabdat. Once you realize God, you will never be repeating the cycle of birth. It will not be a janma, it will become an avatara. It will not be a karma, it will become leela. So it is said, so Krishna will lead you. That he says without saying, in a very poetic way, in an oblique way, he starts saying that. And he also says, when once
you come to the resort of Krishna, you will never be having such problem of birth and rebirth and death and such cycle. That is so beautifully said in a Nindastuti. Nindastuti means apparently it is a blemish, apparently it is cursing a person, but really it is a great prize that we really, really like. Such is that verse. Ayam kshiram bodhe patiriti gavam palakayiti shritosma bhikshiro panayanadiya nandatan nandatanayah anena pratyuho vyarachi vidhina yena janani stanadapyasmakam sakradapipayo durlabhamabhut. Oh, alas! What a mistake it happened. I thought that he is a person who has his residence in Kshirasamudra and who is a cowboy and richly deserves so many cows and he milches every day and even freely gives it away. So thinking that I will be getting plenty of good milk, quality milk, I came to him. What a wretched person and treacherous he is. Not even mother's milk I could get because of him. When will be having mother's milk? Only when they are getting new birth and becoming babies. He will be vanquishing all the cycle of birth and death, and that is the intended meaning. He will be taking away from this wretched cycle of rebirth and re-death and birth and death, and that's why I will be compensated from this and I will be getting liberated. That is the meaning of it. So beautifully he gives out this Nindastuti. And then he says, I hail from the family of devotees of Shiva. Shaivavayam nakalu tatra vicharaniyam panchakshari japapara niratam tathapi cheto madiya matase kusumavabhasam smirananam smarati gopavadhu kishoram. We are devotees of Shiva. We wear Rudraksha, we meditate on Panchakshara Mantra, everything is true. But this boy has stolen my heart. I have lost for him. So I am eloped by him. That's how he says. Cheto Madhiya Matasi Kusumava Bhasam Smerananam Gopavadhu Kishoram. Whatever may be your way of worship, whichever form you may worship, ultimately it goes to Krishna. You have to end up here. Will you think of other things? That's so in a beautiful way he has this wonderful intimate suggestion as well. And then he also requests the flute. This is a very, very beautiful poem, requesting the flute. Please plead my case. For me you plead. What is my situation? You please tell me. Tell him. You recommend my case to Krishna. Ayi Murali Mukunda Smera Vaktra Ravinda Shwasana Madhura Sajne Twam Pranamya Adhyayache Adhara Mani Samipam Prapta Vatyam Bhavatyam Kathaya Rahasi Karne Madhasham Nandasunoho. Oh Murali, you are always having the good fortune of being close to him. Whenever you are in action, you will be very close to his lips, tender lips. Whenever you are not in action, you will be very close to his waist. Sometimes you will be dancing in his palm. Sometimes you will be kissing his lips. Sometimes you will be embracing his waist. These are all the three positions. Nowhere you will be left out. And so you are such an intimate personality. And that's why I am requesting you, sometime in a good mood, when the Lord is in a merry mood, you go close to his ears and whisper my pathetic state of affairs. Here is a wretched devotee. Please look at him. Please take care of him. Endear him. And sanction Paramapada and Moksha. That's all he needs. Nothing else. So please recommend. And this used to be very beautifully sung. And in a very, very intimate way, the meaning is to be enhanced here. Kathaya
ರಹಸಿ ಕಥಯ ಕರ್ಣೇ ಕಥಯ ರಹಸಿ ಕರ್ಣೇ ಕಥಯ ಅಯಿ ಮುರಳಿ ಕಥಯ ಕೃಷ್ಣಸ್ಯ ಕರ್ಣೇ ಕಥಯ ಮದ್ದಶಾಂ ಕಥಯ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಓ ಮುರಳಿ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸೀಕ್ರೆಟ್ ವೇ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ In a secret way, whisper in his ears when he is finding a casual mood of intimacy, like that he is enhancing the meaning. This is how the singer will be enhancing. Mysore Vasudevacharya and such people who knew Sanskrit as well along with music, they used to do it. They used to really bring out the full essence of the shloka as well, and also a raga like Kamajar, Bihagar, such Tumri Prakar ragas of Hindustani music. This is how Leela Shuka's Karanamrita used to be employed in music as well. And he also says, why not I become a flute? ಅಪಿ ಜನುಷಿ ಪರಸ್ಮಿನ್ನಾತ್ತ ಪುಣ್ಯೋ ಭವೇಯಂ ತಟಭುವಿಯಮುನಾಯಾಸ್ತಾದೃಶೋ ವಂಶನಾದಃ ಅನುಭವತಿ ಯಯೇಷ ಶ್ರೀಮದಾಭೀರಸೂನೋಃ ಅಧರ ಮಣಿ ಸಮೀಪನ್ಯಾಸಧನ್ಯಾಂ ಅವಸ್ಥಾಂ. ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜನ್ಮ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬರ್ತ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ as a bamboo on the banks of Yamuna, so that somehow, sometime, Krishna would form me, Krishna would mold me as his flute, and always I'll be having the divine presence of his lips ever attached to me. That's so he feels for the flute as well. These are some of the serious devotional ecstasies of Leela Shuka in Karanamrita. And now he comes to the childhood play of Krishna. In Sanskrit, versification is so beautiful and it's a wonderful play as well. One and all, if they want to versify, they should first opt for Sanskrit. Like English, it is meant for business. Sanskrit is meant for poetry. No other language, I know not less than 18 to 20 languages, both Indian and non-Indian. None of these languages dare come near Sanskrit in the in terms of beauty, in terms of melody, in terms of divinity, in terms of grandeur, in terms of sesquipedalian grandeur and majesty. None languages, no other languages come. And there poetry is composed in the form of conversations, and it's far more difficulty that is being achieved. You see, one conversation, Yashoda and Krishna will be conversing. Yashoda, she has milked fresh milk. She with that pitcher of milk is coming to kitchen, and Krishna says, Mata, Mom, Kim Yadunata, what's my child? Dehi Chashakam, give me a cup. Kim Tena, what for? Patum Payaha, to have milk. Tannastyadya, not now. Kadastiva, when it is. Nishi, in night. Nisha Kimva, what is night? Gadamdakarodaye, when everything becomes pitch dark. Amil Yakshyugam, Nishapyupagata, then Krishna immediately closed his eyes. Now it's pitch dark. Dehi, give me. Matur Muhur Vakshojambara Karshanodyatakaraha, Krishnasa Pushnatunaha. And such a child who mesmerized his mother by closing his eyes. After all, the Paramartha is, when God is closing eyes, Surya and Chandra both are lost. It is Amavasya. So, it's real darkness. When he is sleeping, it is Chaturmasya. We are enjoying his night. It is a divine night. So, put it in a wonderful conversational manner between mother and child. He brings out such a miraculous childhood of Krishna. And in one more poem, Krishna now is for milk, and now in this verse he is not drinking milk. It is the way of children, is it not? When they want it, we are not for giving. When they are not willing, we force them. Parents are always like that. Here many children, many adolescent people. For adolescents, a Sanskrit word is called pauganda. Adolescent and children, these are all people who don't like their parents fussing so much on it. And mother is fussy. Krishna is not for drinking milk. Then she starts cajoling. Somehow she enamors Krishna. Kalindi pulinodaresh musali avadgata khelitum tavat karburikapaya pibhare vardishite te shikha. Krishna, Balarama has gone to play on the sand dunes of Yamuna. Before he comes, you drink away the milk of this black cow. All your hairs will become jet black. They will grow faster. Ittam balataya pratarana para shrutva yashoda giraha payannaha swishikam spishan pramudhisa kshirerdha pite hari. May that Lord protect us who, having heard the words of mother and being enamored, immediately he drinks, he sucks in one sip. Oh mother, yes, yes, it's growing. He started touching his head and saying, it's already growing. This is wonderful childhood. Even real children, they cannot entertain us so well. Only God can entertain. His childhood is Leela. Leela Shishutva, and that is being so well depicted by the poet. And we know how difficult it is to make a child sleep. Krishna has to put to sleep. Then we have to narrate stories. Nowadays, TV or Android phone or WhatsApp or what's down, what else, that's how we have to. But then Yashoda used to narrate stories. And stories means what else apart from Ramayana, Bharata and Bhagavata? These are all the eternal stories. And Yashoda starts narrating Ramayana itself, a story of his other birth. And children always used to end off the story with one sound, like that. Without that, the story would never proceed. It's the Adhara Shruti. She starts narrating, Ramo Nama Babhuva, Tadabala Siteti, Taupitur Vacha Panchavativane Viharataha, Tasyahara Dravanaha, Mohum, Savitre, Kvadhanur, Dhanur, Dhanuriti Vyagragira Pantuvaha. There was a king by name Rama. Well, he was married to Sita. He and Sita, as per the orders of Dasharatha, went to forest alas. Where Ravana kidnapped Sita. No, Lakshmana, where is my bow? Where is my bow? Where is my bow? So Krishna, in all furious mood, he woke up. And that fury of Krishna may protect us. Means Krishna immediately went back to Ramavatara. He equated himself with Rama and then he started feeling for Sita and ordered Lakshmana to bring the bow. And so beautifully poet has suggested Rama and Krishna are one and the same. And narrating a story to Krishna means he'll be recapitulating all that, and this is another Balalila. This you have to see Dr. Padma Subramanian acting. So beautifully she performs. She is the incarnation of Bharata himself, I feel often. Ramo Nama Bhuvahum, like that. So our children should be educated in Ramayana, Mahabharata and Bhagavata. Even the Lord also wanted to listen to his own story. In Valmiki Ramayana Uttarakanda, when the first two bards who started popularizing Ramayana, Lava and Kusha, again child artists, they voluntarily sang the divine story of Rama in the streets of Ayodhya when they came, and also in the royal palace of Ayodhya. Everybody were sitting with a rapt attention. They were listening to Rama was on the throne, and Rama thought, Valmiki says, if I go in the mass and if I enter into the big group of people and there stand and listen to my own story, it will be very more, even more enjoyable. Because we know the gods cannot get only one thing, that is really enjoying the ecstasy of the ocean. That's why our dasas have sung. We have the advantage of singing you. You don't have that. You have the advantage of enjoying your stories, but you don't have.
And that's why Rama thought of enjoying his own story, and he thought, it will be even good for me if I listen to it. Means Ramayana is such a beautiful story, even the enjoyment of Rama was seen there. So the story of Ramayana was appealing to Krishna as well. And one more event from Krishna. Krishna, as usual, has gone to somebody's place to steal away the milk products. He has gone there. And that gopi, he knows, there is a conversation. Kastvam Bala, who are you, my boy? Balanujaha, I am younger brother of Balarama. You see the manipulations. He is not revealing his name, I am Krishna. And so on so. And M. V. Krishna, Madhura Vasudeva Krishna, he is not saying that. He is saying, I am Balanuja, younger brother of Balarama. Let Balarama be blamed. Let his name be remembered and he shall be taken to task. Kimihate, well, what for you are here? Man Mandir Ashankaya, I thought it's my home. Yuktam, well, it can also happen. Me too get confused. So many homes here, they look alike. So many times I too get confused. Krishna should have had like that. Tam Navanita Patri Vivare Hastam Kimartanyase. Well, it's agreed. But how come you are inserting your hand into that pot which contains butter? Mata, Kanchana Vatsakam Rogetum. Mother, I was in search of a calf which escaped. And that's why I am in search of it here. Maga Vishadam Kshana Kityevam Mata Kanchana Vatsakam Rogetum Maga Vishadam Kshana. Like that he said, and such a Krishna, Pushnatunaha, he may protect us. That's the poet's expression at the end. Every such act of Krishna ends up with that benediction, aspiration that his childhood and he may protect us. And then one gopi says, Krishna cannot be conquered. He cannot be confiscated. He steals and runs away. He cajoles and runs away. He enamors and runs away. Unable to catch him, she says, Hastamakshippi yatosi balat Krishna ki madhutam hridayad yadi niryasi paurusham ganayamite. Oh Krishna, you are good enough, you are skilled enough and shrewd enough to run away from my hands. But if you had real guts, would you run away from my heart? Can you run away from my heart? It's impossible for the God. It's impossible for him. So is the deep devotion of this gopi. How many of us can confidently say this? We can capture Krishna in the form of image. We can capture Krishna in the form of painting. But can we make Krishna firm in our hearts? Can we arrest him in our hearts? So difficult it is and so impossible it is, and poet achieves. Yashoda, in one mood, Krishna burbles away big ball of butter and runs. She chases him and says, Neetam yadinavanitam neetam neetam kimetena atapa tapita bhumav madhava madhava madhava. Just you see the language. Neetam yadinavanitam neetam neetam kimetena atapa tapita bhumav madhava madhava madhava. Almost every word is repeating, but its meaning is different. Well, gone is gone. Butter gone means gone. Let it go to dogs, it go to hell. I don't bother. But you are running into the streets. It is sunny day. It's in the summer, scorching sun. In this heat, you are running barefooted. How can I feel it? It's so bad. My heart is burning. Don't run away, Madhava, Madhava, Madhava. Means your lotus-like feet are crushed, are withered away, are even burnt away, charred away. I don't like it. I can't even imagine that. Come back. I shall give you plenty of butter. What all you need, I shall give it. Such a Gopi Yashoda, once what she does? She's churning buttermilk, yogurt for butter. And we know while churning, in a big vessel it is churned, it makes lot of sound, a roaring sound. Krishna comes. Kova Ghoshana Matanoti Kalate Kalashe Matarvada. No? Who is making that big noise inside the pitcher? Who is that? Bhutam, Masprasha, Masprasha. It's devil, don't touch. Panibhyam Navanita Manda Mabalam Prudhritya. Somehow escaping mother's vision, she took away a big bowl of butter and said, Bhutena Dattam Dattam Iti Pramoda Bhritaha. Mom, it's not me who took. It's only that imp, that devil that gave away. So it's not my fault. So he ran away. Krishna Sapushna Atunaha. Such Krishna may be of good to us. That's how another verse of Leela Shuka it goes. And has burgled away butter, has even swallowed. No evidence. But we can infer from the fragrance of fresh butter coming from his mouth. But he is not ready to agree. He is best among thieves. Whatever he does is always best. And it should be so. Vadane navanita gandhavaham vachane taskara chaturi durinam. Mouth is fragrant with fresh butter. But words coming from the mouth, they say, I am not. Tom, Dick and Harry, somebody did so. I am not. Vachane taskara chaturi durinam. His words are even a guiding light to best among the thieves. How to utter lies, Krishna can only know. As Surdas says, Surdas Krishna, Mainahi makhanakaya. So he is saying, Vachane taskara chaturi durinam, Nayane kuhanashram ashrayetha. And all false tears in the eyes. Children first start arguing. If we don't listen to, they start weeping. And even then, they make big noise. Charane komala tandavam kumaram. He making all sort of dance, shuri tandava. I am not. Oh, let it be so. Don't make big noise. Don't make a show. Keep quiet. Like that mother would give some more butter. That's how poet says, and such a mother Yashoda, so blessed she is, n times blessed and n tending to infinity. Yadro omarandhra kuhare varaha janmani babhu urami samudraha tam namana tam aravinda drishan Yashoda padidvayantara jale snapayam babhuva. Yadro omarandhra kuhareshu viniveshita sagara sapta. Even in the pits of the hairs, we know when the skin is cross-sectioned, we have dermis, epidermis and other things, and there we have the hairs, and next to hairs we have the sweat glands, they have the depression. All the seven oceans were lost somewhere in the Roma Kupa of Mahavishnu when he took the incarnation of Mahavaraha and wanted to resurrect Mother Earth in the deeps of oceans. And to such a person, even the oceans were not sufficient to drench him. Mother Yashoda is making him showered and drenched. She is giving bath to him with palm full of water. My friend Mr. Govind used to say, in Bay Area, no water scarcity is there. In 2 minutes you have to finish shower, switching on 1 minute and switching off another minute. And Krishna would also feel bad for this. Here, Yashoda would do, in Kannada we say, un bogase. In Sanskrit we say, un chaluka. Chaluka means handful of water. With one handful of water, she would drench Krishna. But in Varahavatara, what a contrast. He would yield to bhakti. In one of the compositions of Nammalvar in Tamil, very great devotee Nammalvar, Kutastha Prapanna Kutastha, that's how it is, he is being hailed. And he
says in his Tiruvai Moli, it goes the some of summarizing of that, it goes like that. Yashoda wanted to tie Krishna so that he will never move. No amount of ropes were sufficient. He is Damodara, he is Vishwodara also. Any amount of Damas, ropes will not be sufficient. Yashoda exhausted the home, exhausted the village, exhausted the stores, exhausted all malls, but she couldn't. Then Krishna, in all compassion for mother, wanted to see that his mother should win, should become successful in tying him. He contracted, and so with the rope, whatever remaining, he could be tied out. That so is the compassion, and poet says. And then when Krishna came dancing in an early morning, when she was churning for butter, she saw Krishna being reflected on the walls. Dutyantam atyanta vilokaniyam krishnam manistam bhagatam mrigakshi vilokya saksha diva krishnam agre dvidha vitene navaneetam ekam. When Krishna started dancing, the poem itself is so dancing. Dutyanta matyanta vilokaniyam krishnam manistam bhagatam mrigakshi vilokya saksha diva krishnam agre dvidha vitene navaneetam ekam. When Krishna came dancing and his reflection fell so well on the mirror polished walls, then she confused, as though two Krishnas are there. One ball of butter which she wanted to offer, she divided that into two and started offering to Bimba and Pratibimba as well. So is the charm of Krishna. And this Krishna himself got enamored by his own reflection. That is in another verse, poet says, Ratnasthale Janucharah Kumarah Sankranta Matmiya Mukhara Vindam Adatuka Mastada Labdha Kedat Ruroda Vilokya Dhatri Vadanam Ruroda. Krishna was moving on the knees. In Kannada we call that as Ambegalu. It means moving on the knees. The children do so. Janucharanam, that's what we say. Janu means the knees. When he was moving, naturally, on the mirror-polished floor, his face got reflected. Children naturally have the tendency of identifying the image as another object, another child. He started touching and wanted to get the baby also, wanted to get the that child also for a play. Unable to, looking at mother's face, started weeping. Vilokya Dhatri Vadaram Ruroda says, such a Krishna is always a universal darling. One gopi who was completely absorbed in Krishna went to the marketplace to sell the milk products, dairy products. Vikretu kama kila gopa kanya murari padar pita chitta vritti dadhyadikam mohavashada vochat govinda damodara madhaveti. And one who went in all ecstasy of Krishna to the marketplace with a basket full of milk products, instead of saying, here is milk, here is butter, here is yogurt, and here is buttermilk, started saying, Govinda here, Damodara here, Narayana here, Madhava here, like that. That is the attraction of Krishna, the poet says. Then, how Krishna plays the flute? What happens when he is on to music? Kalindi bahula pravaha rabasam tansa samstambhayan takshanat shailan vidravayan mrigan vivashayan govrindamanandayan gopan vibramayan munin mukulayan saptaswaran jrambhayan omkar artha mudirayan vijayate vumshini nadashishoho. When Krishna is on playing flute, the flowing Yamuna got freezed. The dynamics of Yamuna became statics, and the static nature of mountains changed to dynamism. When mountains started melting, animals started dancing, trees started clapping, and the cowherds started enjoying, and the sages got engrossed, and the seven modes appeared in the human form and started dancing,
and the message of Upanishads was revealing through the music of flute. Omkararth mudirayan vijayate vumshi ninada shishoho. Like that he says. And such a Krishna, when he was in a row with Radha or Satyabhama, she never allowed Krishna to enter into the harem. The doors were locked. Naturally, Krishna is Mr. Charm. Every woman falls for him. What to do? Krishna would entertain here and there, and she would not tolerate it, and that's why the doors were closed. Was tapping the door. Then she asks, Angulya kakkavatam praharati. Who is tapping the door? Kutile Madhavaha. How crooked I am, Madhava. In Sanskrit, double entry is so common. Puns. Double meaning in the right sense, not with respect to Indian films nowadays. Madhava means Ma Lakshmi, Dhava Lord, Lord of Lakshmi. Another is Madhoha Yam Madhava. Madhu is the first month in spring, Vasanta Ritu's first month, Chaitra. And connected with that is Madhava. It means spring season itself. Kim Vasantaha? Well, spring, is it the season coming into? I don't want spring now. I'm in deep cold. So she is saying, Madhava Kim Vasantaha? No Chakri, no is English, no as well. I'm Chakri. I'm having a discus in my hand, Chakra. Kim Kulalaha? Even a potter has wheel. Even potter's Chakra is known. Nahi Dharani Dharaha? I'm not a potter, I'm Dharanidhara, I'm Varahaswami. Even Adishesha, according to our mythology, is supporting Mother Earth and his roots. Kim Vijahvo Bhujangaha? Are you Adishesha, the double-tongued? There, another subtle taunt is also there. You said something to me, and you said some other thing to that girl, and you went for a date with her, and you have double-crossed me. So, Dvijihvaha, Bhujangaha. Bhujanga means a voluptuous person, voluptuous person as well, apart from a snake. Naham, I am not that. Ghorahi Mardi, I have vanquished a serpent. Kaliya Mardana. Kimasi Kagapati, are you a kite, Garuda? No, Harihi, I am not. I am Hari. Hari means Vishnu. Haratiti Harihi. He takes away all our sins. He takes our heart. That is the meaning of Hari. Hari also means monkey. Kim Kapindraha. Are you a monkey? Ityevam Gopakanya or Satyabhama Prativacharajita Patuva Padmapani Padma Nabha. So Krishna too had no answer in front of a gopi. Well, even gods cannot meet, gods cannot match women in arguments. That is proved by Leela Shuka as well. Then poet says, I don't need any ritual. I am enough with Krishna. Sandhya Vandana Badramastu Bhavate Bhosna Natubhyam Namaha Bho Devaha Pitarascha Tarpana Vidho Nahamkshamaksham Yatam Yatrakva Pinishidya Yadava Kulottamsasya Kamsadvishaha Smaram Smaram Agham Harami Tadalam Manye Kimanyena Me. Oh Sandhya Vandana, may good happen to you. I bless you for your fortune. Please go. Bhosnana Tubhyam Namaha. Oh holy bath, salutations to you. I don't need you anymore. Bho Devaha. Oh other gods. Tarpana Vidho Naham Kshamakshamyatam. I don't need any Amavasya Tarpana. I don't need any other form of eulogizing you and also perigaric offerings. Nothing, nothing I need. Yatrakwa Pinishidya. Somewhere at some place, some nook or corner, I shall sit quietly. Yadava Kulottamsasya Kamsadvisha Smaram Smaram Agham Harami Tadalam Manye Kimanyename. Somewhere at some place I shall sit quietly and remember the names of my Lord. That's enough. It will all take care of my Sandhyavandanam, Sananam, Tarpanam, whatever, whatever, whatever. Everything can be done with it. And so I don't need anything. That's why he says,
And then he says, how wonderful you are, how unthinkable you are, and how indescribable you are. Balopi shailodharanagrapani neelopi nirandhratamapradeepah dheeropi radha nayanavabaddah jaropi samsara harah kutastvam. You are a child, but you can lift the mountain on your small finger for a week. It is one small leela for you. You are pitch dark in color, you are dark, but you dispel darkness of all janmas, and you dispel the very darkness of our ignorance. Neelopi nirandratamah pradeepah. You are very courageous, but if Radha looks at you with one frown, you shudder. What's your confidence? And you are a womanizer, Jara, but you are the person who liberates all of us from these attachments. What a divine voluptuousness is yours. Jagadadaraniya jarabhavam jalajapatya vacho vicharagamyam. That's what he says. How to say you are Gopika Jara, Navaneet Chora? So difficult a thing. I'm unable to understand your leela. That's what he says. And you see, Krishna's birth happened in utter darkness. It was like this. Dakshinayana. Dakshinayana is the night of gods, and it was in Krishna Paksha, night of Pitris, our forefathers, and it was night, the darkness of all rishis and human beings. Deva, Rishi, Pitri, Manava, all people had darkness. In that time of darkness, a dark boy was born behind the bars and would liberate one and all from all bondage and lead to light and delight as well. What an ununderstandable riddle it is, and such a beautiful riddle as well. He says, I got to know. Gopalajira kardame viharase vipradvare lajjase gushe godhana hunkrutaihi stutashateir monam vidhatse vidam dasyam gokula pushchalishu kurushe swamyam nadantatmasu jnatam krishna tavangri pankajigam premachalam manjulam. O Krishna, you roll happily on the cow dung of cowherds, but you deny, you don't want to come to sacrificial altars which are prepared and invoked by sages as well. You answer with all affection even for the sounds of cows, but you pay a deaf ear to the Vedic chantings of Brahmanas. You are ready to become slave to voluptuous women and audacious women of Gokula, but you never want to become master of great seers and sages. Ah, what an irony it is, but I came to know about that. You answer only to love, you fall only to love. You are only for love and nothing but love and love alone. So this divine love, that's what it can move you, and I'm willing for that. Let me pay that, he says. And thus the poet, he concludes, Yavanname naradasha dashamidrishepi randhadudeti timiri krita sarvabhava lavanya keli sadanam tavatavadetu lakshmya samutkunita venu mukhindu bindam. When my life is bidding farewell, saying goodbye to me and going out of my body, before that let my eyes, it is said, the very breath, it may go through the Brahmarandra, that is called Vidruti according to Aitareya Upanishad. That is only for yogis and sages, and to good people through the eyes. Like that, I am one among the good. So, through my eyes, my life may depart. Before that, I just want to have one glance at you. Come in front of me once, just once, with Venu, with flute in your hands. That's all. That's all I need, nothing more, he says. And ultimately he says, ಯಾ ಪ್ರೀತಿರ್ ವಿದುರಾರ್ಪಿತೆ ಮುರರಿಪೋ ಕುಂಚರ್ಪಿತೆ ಯಾದೃಶಿ ಭಾರದ್ವಾಜ ಸಮರ್ಪಿತೆ ಶಬರಿಕಾ ದತ್ತೇ ಧರೆ ಯೋಷಿತಾಂ ಯಾ ಗೋವರ್ಧನ ಮೂರ್ಧ್ನಿ ಯಾ ಚ ಪೃಥುಕೆ ಸ್ತನ್ಯೇ ಯಶೋದಾರ್ಪಿತೆ ಯಾ ಪ್ರೀತಿರ್ ಮುನಿ ಪತ್ನಿ ಭಕ್ತಿ ರಚಿತಾಪ್ಯತ್ರಾಪಿ ತಂ ತಾಂ ಕುರು ಓ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಫೇವರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯು ಯುವರ್ ಲವ್ ಮೇ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮೇ ಸ್ಟೇ ಮೇ sit for a while in my work. Your love shall be showered for a while on my work as well. What sort of love? That love you gave to Kunti, your paternal aunt, and that love you cast on Vidura, and that love you cast on one handful of pounded rice given by Sudhama, and that love you gave to Yashoda for breast milk, and that love you showered on Mount Govardhana for you lifted that for a week, and that love you had for the tender lips of Gopikas, and that love you had for the Adivasi women who used to come with forest fruits, berries, fetching berries for you, and that love you had for every people who loved you, and that shall be with me. Thus Leela Shukas Krishna Karanavrata is a saga of love, is a song of love, is a poem of love, and is life of love. And any living being on earth, or even inanimate thing on earth, if that is, or it is, or she is, or he is touched by these poems of Karanamrita, its life, his life and her life would certainly be rewarded. And I got an opportunity in this land, which is far away from my motherland, and yet our people are there. As Mamu says, where our people are there, it becomes India. So I have created a mini India here and a Vrindavana here, and we are fast approaching Krishna Janmashtami in 2-3 days, on Sunday of course. This auspicious occasion, you have made me sing my beloved poem of Karanamritakara, and I thank you for showering this opportunity and this grace on me. Thank you. Om Tat Sat. Kripaya. Any questions on Krishna, let me try to answer. It's a bonus for me. Aha. Avashyam. Avashyam Karishye. Vrindavanam ಲಸತಿ ಯಾಮುನ ತೀರ ದೇಶೇ ಬೃಂದಾವನಂ ಲಸತಿ ಯಾಮುನ ತೀರ ದೇಶೇ ತದ್ವಾಪರೇ ಬೃಂದಾವನಂ ಲಸತಿ ಯಾಮುನ ತೀರ ದೇಶೇ ತದ್ವಾಪರೇ ಕಿಲ ತದ್ವಾಪರೇ ಕಿಲ ಕಥನ್ನು ಸಮುದ್ರ ತೀರೇ ತದ್ವಾಪರೇ ಕಿಲ ಕಥನ್ನು ಸಮುದ್ರ ತೀರೇ ಸಮುದ್ರ ತೀರೇ ಗೋಪಾಂಗನಾ ಗೋಪಾಂಗನಾ ವ್ರಜ ಕಿಶೋರಚಯಾ ಗೋಪಾಂಗನಾ ವ್ರಜ ಕಿಶೋರಚಯಾ ಕಥನ್ನು ಭಾಂತ್ಯತ್ರ ಚೇತಿ ಭಾಂತ್ಯತ್ರ ಚೇತಿ ಮುರಜಿತ್ ಭಜತೆ ಭ್ರಾಂತ್ಯತ್ರ ಚೇತಿ ಮುರಜಿತ್ ಭಜತೆ ಮುದಂ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯಮುನಾ ವಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಯುಗ ದ್ವಾಪರ ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ಕಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಸೀ ಶೋರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ದ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಸೀ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಪೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಪ ಕಿಶೋರಾಸ್ ಐ ಮೇ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ನೌ Well, there somebody wanted to ask some question. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್.
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವಧಾನಂ ಆಶುಕವಿತ್ವಂ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವಧಾನಂ. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್.
ವಾಟ್
ಲೀಲಾಶೋಕಾಸ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಕರ್ಣಾಮೃತ ಡೀಲ್ಸ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾಸ್ ಬಾಲಲೀಲಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಡೀಪ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲವ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಎಟರ್ನಲ್ ಟ್ರೂತ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಲೇಟರ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿವೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇವನ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಸೂರದಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇವನ್ ದಿ ಅಷ್ಟಚಾಪ್ ಕವೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಜಭಾಷಾ ಇನ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಆರ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೀರಾಬಾಯ್ ಆರ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಶಂಕರ ದೇವ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಸ್ಸಾಂ ಕಾಮರೂಪ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನರಸಿಂಹ ಮೆಹತಾ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಗುಜರಾತ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಅಭಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾರಕರಿ ಸಂಪ್ರದಾಯ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ 4,000 ಸಾಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಳ್ವಾರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ತಮಿಳ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪೊಯಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೇರಳ ಪೊಯೆಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ತೆಲುಗು ಪೊಯೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ನಮಾಚಾರ್ಯ ನಾಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹರಿದಾಸಾಸ್ we don't find greater detail of krishna's later life krishna's later life is completely exploited by bhagwan vedavyasa and vyasa alone who else but vedavyasa can reveal it these aspects of krishna which have become far more important to us as a statesman as a visionary for that you can as well refer to the 8-volume work Krishnavatara, written by Kanhailal Manikyalal Munshi of Gujarat, who was the founder of Bharati Vidyabhavan, a very great statesman, freedom fighter, and a very great writer of merit, high merit. In English he has written. And also you can refer to Purushottama, one more novel in Hindi. And then in Kannada, Bhairappa's Parvas, one section is there. The realistic picture of Krishna is given in a very profound way. That is the recapitulation of Krishna's manifolded achievements and totality in the glimpses of one Yadava hero, Yudhana Satyaki. These are some of the references which I can give. Dhanyavada.
Expelling darkness by bringing light in front of the eyes is very common. But expelling darkness by filling our karanas with an amruta called Krishna is very difficult. And who else has been bestowed with that power to do but the Sakshat Ganesha himself? So, the only thing I can say for that is Krishnaya Tubhyam Namaha. Thank you very much. We have other talks by Ganesh ji as dates progress. On Saturday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. his talk is hosted by the Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangha HSS. And on Sunday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. at Sri Satyanarayana Temple. And also the Learn Sanskritam is being propagated by the Samskrita Bharati. Thank you very much. Om Swastihi.